The second thing that happens after you perfect your tawbah, this is amazing, brothers and sisters. Pay attention to this. When you sin and you repent, Allah substitutes your evil with a good deed. You get rewarded for committing a sin. You will get rewarded for the sin you have done. Not because of the sin, but because of the tawbah. Allah says in the Quran, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. Whoever repents and does good deeds, Allah will substitute, will exchange for the evil that he has done. Allah will give him a good deed in its place. You will be rewarded for the sins you have done as long as you repent from those sins. The third thing that Allah promises to the repentant is Allah promises him extra blessings in this world. Extra money, extra children and wealth and health. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises those who repent that they will be blessed with the good of this world along with the hereafter. And you can read this in the story of the Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. The Prophet Nuh alayhi salam told his people, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُ رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. I told my people to seek Allah's forgiveness. Allah is the one who forgives. When you forgive, when you ask Allah's forgiveness, what happens? يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. Allah will send the rain upon you with beautiful rain. And Allah will increase your money and increase your children. And Allah will give you many gardens and Allah will give you many rivers under them. When you repent, Allah will bless you with the blessings of this world. And the final blessing that we will mention is that repentance is a cause for entering paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, the only people who will enter paradise are those who have done tawbah. The only people, illa man taba, except those who do tawbah, wa amana wa amina salihan, fa ulaika yadkhuluna al-jannah. They will be the ones who will enter Jannah. O Muslims, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you were to stop committing sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would get rid of you. Listen to this hadith, amazing hadith. If you were to stop committing sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would get rid of you and bring forth a group of people who commit sins. Why? Does Allah love sinners? No. Allah does not love sinners. What did the Prophet ﷺ say? He would bring a group of people who commit sins so that they could ask Allah's forgiveness and so that Allah could then forgive them. Allah does not love sins, but Allah loves to forgive. Allah does not love the sinner, but Allah loves the repenter. And to be a repenter, you must be a sinner before you reach the stage of repentance. I conclude this talk by quoting a beautiful hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, where he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will draw close to the believer and cover him up in a private covering that nobody can be between them. And Allah will ask him, did you not do this sin? And the believer will say, yes. And Allah will say, did you not do this sin? The believer will say, yes. And Allah will continue to count each and every sin until the believer thinks that he has been destroyed. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then tell him, just as I hid these sins from the other people in this world, so too today I shall hide them up from the eyes of all. Just like your sins were private, just like you used to keep your sins between you and me and ask me for forgiveness, so too today I shall cover up all of your sins and erase them and you will not be called for them. And that very person will enter the garden of paradise. O Muslims, Allah does not count the quantity of your sins. Allah does not count how often you turn to Him. In a hadith Qudsi, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that when a sinner commits a sin, he raises his hands to Allah and he says, oh Allah, forgive me. Allah says to the angels, look, my servant has sinned, I have forgiven him. The servant commits the sin the second time. He raises his hands to Allah, says, oh Allah, forgive me. The angels once again are told, look at my servant, he has sinned and I have forgiven him. And then the servant commits the sin for the third time. What does Allah say? Does he say this is a sinner, hopeless? No. He tells the angels, "Oh my angels, I bear witness that you testify that I have forgiven this servant no matter what he does." Why? Because he recognizes that I am his Lord, that he has sinned, and that he must turn to me for forgiveness. That is what Allah wants from us, to recognize him to be the Lord, to turn to him for forgiveness. O Muslims, turn to the Ghaffar, turn to the Ghafoor, turn to the Rahman, turn to the Rahim. And when you do so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your repentance and bless you in this world and the hereafter. That is the true courageous man. That is the real sinner. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be amongst those who repent from the sins and accept that repentance and resurrect us on the Day of Judgment in the company of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala di Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.